At 3:38 p.m. on April 11, 2012, something crazy yet true occurred. In Indonesia, a major earthquake struck, causing by the time the earthquake had ended, the ground to be offset by as much as a whopping 52 meters or 170.6 feet. Before I explain why or even just how this occurred, I want to just showcase how absurd of a figure this is. On the left, we have an American football field. On the right, we have a football field which is called soccer in the United States. Let's assume that these fields have a fault line running through them of the same type during the aforementioned earthquake. After the lengthy 184-second earthquake had ended, the two sports fields would have looked like this. So, clearly, this earthquake must have been absolutely devastating, ripping large buildings clean in half, right? Nope. While this earthquake did result in casualties and even a minor tsunami, the whopping 52-meter offset thankfully occurred solely underwater. The strongest ground motion a populated landmass felt was MMI 6 on a small section of northwestern Sumatra, which for reference would have caused shaking similar to this simulation. This magnitude 8.6 earthquake represented the largest known example to have occurred on a specific type of fault line, specifically a strike-slip fault line. Strike-slip faults involve horizontal rather than vertical motion from two sides of a fault sliding past one another. Offshore of the west coast of northern Sumatra, there are, depending on how you count it, three or four tectonic plate boundaries. To the east, you have the Burma microplate, which is sometimes considered its own distinct tectonic plate, while others consider it to be part of the much larger Sunda plate. Heading west, you have the Indo-Australian plate to the southwest and the Indian plate to the northwest. Both of these plates are colliding with their counterparts to the east, but this collision is not occurring straight on, but rather through north-northeast movement. In other words, there is far more northerly than easterly motion of the Indian and Indo-Australian plates. As a result, stresses can build up on a portion of the Indian plate as a portion of it attempts to slowly break apart into its own distinct microplate, eventually being released by a series of large strike-slip faults. However, this doesn't explain why such a large offset occurred. What does, however, is the manner in which earthquake magnitudes are calculated, specifically with a moment magnitude scale. When an earthquake occurs, a rupture of a specific length and width moves a specific average amount. Since the number figure of these three values are multiplied together using this formula, a certain magnitude earthquake can represent a wide range of possible values. For example, here are the values for 7 21st century magnitude 7.8 earthquakes which occurred worldwide. Note how the ratios between the length and width greatly vary, and how the steeper the incline of the fault plane is, the more significant the maximum slip values are. Since strike-slip faults essentially move purely horizontally, the fault plane has an angle of 90 degrees, marking the steepest it can get. The greater the angle is, the more oblong the slip rectangle will be. Thus, the further apart the ratios of two values get when you get similar additive values, the lower the multiplied values will be. Thus, to get the same magnitude for a strike-slip fault earthquake as an earthquake on any other fault type, generally speaking, the larger the maximum slip must be. And, very large strike-slip fault earthquakes of magnitude 8.5 or larger are absurdly rare, only being known to have occurred twice, once at this Indonesia 2012 earthquake and once in the far eastern Tibetan plateau in 1950. Since the Indonesian quake was the largest strike-slip fault earthquake ever recorded, it produced one of the largest fault offsets in recorded history. Adding another level of complexity, note the unusualness of the earthquake duration chart for the 2012 Indonesian quake. It seems, per one source at least, that not one, but four different large strike-slip faults ruptured at different intervals in the overall quake, which added together to create an extreme displacement. Only one earthquake has ever created a larger maximum offset, a 56 to 62 meter offset during Japan's deadly 2011 megathrust earthquake of magnitude 9.1. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Michael Guerin, for supporting my work.